بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome to our weekly program at Osaka Ibaraki Masjid. And inshallah, this is time for Quran and Tajweed class, inshallah. As usual, we used to recite one page of Al-Quran al-Kareem, and then I gave some explanations about the meaning of the ayat, and then we talk about the rules of Tajweed of the same ayat. So alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters who are following us in this class, of course, they will be improving in their recitation and in their tajweed. And as I always advise, the rules of tajweed are so many. So you cannot learn it in one time. But every time, try to learn a little bit of the rules. And one of the good ideas is to have a small note with you and to write after me. Otherwise, what you will listen, if you don't write, easy to forget it. So my advice to brothers and sisters, to have a small note with you and then to write the things you think it's important for you. Today we'll recite the ayat Surah Al-Shu'ara from ayah 61 until ayah 83. If you have this mushaf, the page number is 370. inshallah. So inshallah, shall we start? 370 from ayah Ash-Shu'ara. Yes, from ayah 61 until 83. Now you can see the ayat. Inshallah, shall we start? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فلما ترى الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى remember tara'a, we make it four harakat. Tara'a. Yes, four harakat. This we say mad wajib muttasil. Mad wajib muttasil. Also the gunna. Falamma mim shadda nun shadda we make gunna. So if you take care about these two, the recitation will go, mashallah, smoothly. فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى ما شاء الله. فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. قال كلا قال كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. إن معي ربي سيهدين فأوحينا إلى موسى أن اضرب بعصاك البحر فأوحينا إلى موسى أن اضرب بعصاك البحر أن اضرب بعصاك البحر فانفلق فكان كل فرق كالطود العظيم. فانفلق فكان كل فرق كالطود العظيم. كل فرق كالطود العظيم وأزلفنا ثم الآخرين. وأزلفنا ثم الآخرين وأنجينا موسى ومن معه أجمعين. وأنجينا موسى ومن معه أجمعين. ومن معه أجمعين ومن معه أجمعين ثم أغرقنا الآخرين. ثم أغرقنا الآخرين إن في ذلك لآية إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين. وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن رب ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم. وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم. واتل عليهم نبأ إبراهيم. واتل عليهم نبأ إبراهيم إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما تعبدون. إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما تعبدون. قالوا نعبد أصناما فنظل لها عاكفين. قالوا نعبد أصناما فنظل لها عاكفين. قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون. قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون. أو ينفعونكم أو يضرون. أو ينفعونكم أو يضرون. قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون. قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون. قال أفرأيتم ما كنتم تعبدون. قال أفرأيتم ما كنتم تعبدون. أنتم وآباؤكم الأقدمون. أنتم وآباؤكم الأقدمون. فإنهم عدو لي. فإنهم عدو لي إلا رب العالمين. إلا رب العالمين الذي خلقني فهو يهدين. الذي خلقني فهو يهدين. والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين. والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين. وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين. وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين. والذي يميتني ثم يحيين. والذي يميتني ثم يحيين. والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي. والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي. أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. خطيئتي. أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. رب هب لي حكما. رب هب لي حكما. وألحقني بالصالحين. وألحقني بالصالحين. رب هب لي حكما وألحقني بالصالحين.
الحمد لله. We recited the ayat together. Now, inshallah, I will recite the ayat for you.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فلما تراءى الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. قال كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. فأوحينا إلى موسى أن اضرب بعصاك البحر فانفلق فكان كل فرق كالطود العظيم. وأزلفنا ثم الآخرين. وأنجينا موسى ومن معه أجمعين. ثم أغرقنا الآخرين. إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم واتل عليهم نبأ إبراهيم إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما تعبدون قالوا نعبد أصناما فنظل لها عاكفين قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون أو ينفعونكم أو يضرون قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون قال أفرأيتم ما كنتم تعبدون أنتم وآباؤكم الأقدمون فإنهم عدو لي إلا رب العالمين الذي خلقني فهو يهدين والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين والذي يميتني ثم يحيين والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين رب هب لي حكما وألحقني بالصالحين الحمد لله we recited the ayat alhamdulillah two times. Now the meaning of the ayat, inshallah. We're still in the story of the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. When Fir'aun and his army, they followed Musa alayhi salam. And Musa and Bani Israel became in front of the water. So there is no way to escape from Fir'aun. So the first ayah we recited today, فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ When Fir'aun and his army came behind Musa alayhi salam and the Bani Israel, and then in front of them the water. So Musa and Bani Israel, they had no place to go. There is no place to escape. At that time, قال أصحاب موسى. أصحاب موسى means Bani Israel. Okay? They said, إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ Fir'aun will capture us. There is no way. إِنَّا لمدركون. Then موسى عليه السلام said, قال كلا. Not at all. موسى عليه السلام said, not at all. كلا. إن معي ربي سيهدي. Allah is with me and he will find for us some way. This is a يقين. يقين in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So look to the yaqeen of Bani Israel and the yaqeen of Musa. Big difference. Musa alayhi salam qala kalla, not at all. They will not capture us. Inna ma'ya Rabbi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with me and he will find some way for us. At the time, fa'awhayna. You remember, brothers, before I talk about fa. In Al-Quran or in the Arabic language. ف. What is the meaning of fa? Yes. Yes. Immediately after fa. So we have in the Arabic language, we have fa and we have thumma. So we have two. The meaning almost same, but fa means immediately happened. For example, you know the Prophet Yunus alayhi salam. Yunus alayhi salam. When he was in the stomach of the whale, what he said, the dua of Yunus alayhi salam, what he said, la ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin, la ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. This what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Al-Quran. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا. We accepted his dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say, ثُمَّ اسْتَجَبْنَا. But he said, فَه. فَه means, immediately after he made the dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to his dua. So, this fa in the Arabic language having we can say secret. It means something happened immediately. Now, Musa alayhi salam said to his people, Kalla, not at all. Allah is with me and he will find some way for me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fa. Means after he said that, direct. Immediately, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him wahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fa'awhayna. Allah gave him wahi. Anidrib bi'asaka al-hajar. Al-bahr. Idrib bi'asaka al-bahr. The stake you have, just beat the water. Just throw it to the water. And then what happened? فانفلق. سبحان الله. انفلق. It means the water getting two parts. Not two parts actually. More. 12 parts. 12. It became 12 parts. Why 12? Yes, yes. For Bani Israel, they are 12 tribes. Because Yaqub alayhi salam, he had 12 people, 12 sons. From each son, there are family. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when ordered Musa to beat the water, then the water became 12 for each one of them to go. There is one way to go. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقْ each part كَالطَّوْضِ الْعَظِيمِ like the big mountain. Okay, so subhanallah, the water stopped. Like if you can imagine like puts like some glass. So the water behind. So the water became like stopped. And then Bani Israel, they went and escaped from Pharaoh. Pharaoh, he followed them. He also entered with his army. But then when he became in the middle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the water to come again. So subhanallah, when Pharaoh was about to die, he said, آمنت this in Al Quran. آمنت بالذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل وأنا من المسلمين. آمنت I believe of what بني إسرائيل believed. I believe in Allah. وأنا من المسلمين and I am one of the Muslim people. Okay. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى said to him in the next ayah, الآن. And actually, this word الآن. Now you became believer. Now, not benefiting you because you are in the at the time of death. That's why we say the tawbah, the gate of tawbah open for everyone, except in two times. At the time of sakarat al-maut, the gate of tawbah closed. Because at the time of sakarat al-maut, the veil removed. So you can see everything. Now we cannot see because there is some veil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make some veil for us. We cannot see the akhirah. We cannot see malaika. We cannot see things. There is some hidden. But at the time of death, this veil removed. So a person will see by his own eyes everything clearly. So at the time to say, I am mu'min, not accepted. Because now everything is clear. Huh? To be a true mu'min, الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. Those who believe in غيب. غيب means unseen. This is the meaning of mu'min. Mu'min means you believe in something you don't see. You believe in Allah. Did you see Allah? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. But you believe in him. You believe in Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You didn't see him now. He was before. You believe in malaika, jinn, all things. Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us we believe. Okay. وَأَنْجَيْنَا مُوسَى. Look here also brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said wa. After that, he said wa, not fa. Wa anjayna. And we saved Musa and Bani Israel. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say fa? Because it takes time. It takes time to go and to pass and to go to other side. Takes time. So that's why Allah said wa. Not fa. But after Musa alayhi salam said Allah is with me, Allah said fa. Direct. Immediately. We helped him. Inna fi dhalika la ayah. It's a very great sign. What happened to Fir'aun? Great sign. وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. And not all of them, or most of them, they are not mu'min. They are not believers. This ayah, you will find it's repeated many times in the surah. This ayah, you will find it repeating many times. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. For Fir'aun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةٌ. Allah said to him that in Al-Quran, when Fir'aun said, I am now believing in Allah in Bani Israel. And also something important, brothers. Fir'aun, according to the ayah, he said, I believed in what بني إسرائيل believed. Look, he didn't say I believe in Allah. You know, if he said Allah, this maybe could save him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't make this word come into his tongue. He said, I believe in what Bani Israel believing. He could say, I believe in Allah. But he didn't say. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, فاليوم, فا, also فا, فا, فاليوم, today, ننجيك ببدنك. You will be saved, or your body will be saved after death. We will save your body. Okay? Why? لتكون لمن خلفك آية. To be آية, sign for all people coming after you. So subhanAllah, until now, his body, you can see it in the museum in Egypt. The body of Pharaoh still exists until now. All people can see. And you can see his mouth open. Subhanallah, when you see his mummy, scary. Then the next ayat, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ إِبْرَاهِيمِ. أُتْلُ, this is order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell نَبَأَ إِبْرَاهِيم, the news about the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ. When Ibrahim alayhi salam said to his people, what you are worshipping? قالوا نعبد أصناما فنظل لها عاكفين. We worship statues and we are spending time for worshipping it. قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون. He asked them another question. Do the idols hearing you? يسمعونكم, when you pray for them, when you pray to them, do they listen to you? أو ينفعونكم أو يضرون. Do they benefiting or harming you? Of course, there is no answer. So the answer of them, they said, we found our grants. We found our grants did that. We found our elders doing that. قال أفرأيتم ما كنتم تعبدون. He said, what you and your ancestors was worshipping, it's an enemy for me, except رب العالمين, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رب العالمين. الذي خلقني فهو يهدين. Who created me and who will guide me to the right. والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين. The one who gave me the rizq, the provision, giving me the food, water. It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the source for feeding and giving the provision to people. وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. When I become sick, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who cured me. وَالَّذِي يُمِيتُنِي ثُمَّ يُحْيِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who will take my life and then giving me life again in the akhirah. Actually, brothers, all of those things دعوة. يعني موسى عليه السلام making دعوة to his people. Okay, to his people. When he asked them, the idols listening to you, they said no. Can benefiting you, can harm you. And the answer, we do what our grands used to do. Then he started to make da'wah to them, explaining to them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Allah, the one who created me. Okay? The one who giving us provision. The one who take care of us when we are sick. The one who taking life from us and then giving it again in the hereafter. The one I hope he will forgive my sins in the day of judgment. Then he ended his dua. رب هب لي حكما وألحقني بالصالحين. This also dua, we can all say this dua. This dua, everyone can say. رب هب لي حكما وألحقني بالصالحين. يا الله, give me or provide me by wisdom and make me attached with the righteous people to be with them. So inshallah next week we'll start from the ayah 84, also continuation of the story of the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Okay, now let's go to the tajweed. فَلَمَّا غُنَّ. And this very simple rule of tajweed. When you see نون شَدَّ or ميم شَدَّ, تجديد. نون تجديد, ميم تجديد, you make غُنَّ. غُنَّ means to stop on the noon or mean, like this one. Look, I said falamma. I didn't say falamma. I stopped on the mean. Falamma. This is the gunna. And when you stop for gunna, some voice coming from your nose. Falamma. Yes, that's why you say gunna, gunna, gunna means something coming from the nose. طراء. This one we say مد واجب. مد واجب متصل. Why? Because the مد and then همزة after مد in the same word. طراء. 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 So we have the mad and then after mad there is hamza. So and this is one word usually for the if I write it not in Al-Quran, I will write like this. We say this alif maqsura, like this. But in Al-Quran, look, it's written alif. Both are okay, but this is alif, this one for Uthmani Mus'haf. One thing we learned when we childhood, when we start to memorize Al-Quran, one of the lessons to write Al-Quran in the Uthmani writing, this one, because sometimes there are some differences between Uthmani writing and the daily life or the Arabic, current Arabic writing, like this one. Like for example, also the word as-salah. In the daily life, we write as-salah like this, as-salah. Like this. Okay? But in Al-Quran, you will not find like this. In Al-Quran, how to write? Mu'in. Like this. So they put waw. As-salah. They make waw. But in our now current, when we write as-salah like this one. We don't write like this one. But this one, Uthmani. You have to write it as the Mus'haf Uthmani. Many examples in Al-Quran. So this one, Tara'a. This one, Mad, and then Hamza. In one word, we say Mad Wajib Muttasil. We make it four harakat. Tara'a. Four. Okay? الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى إن. Now we have another one. موسى إن. Brother, yes, you can see. موسى, then إن. We have مد and then همزة. But this one, two words. Not like the first one. First one, one word. That's why first one we say مد واجب متصل. Second one we say جائز منفصل. مد جائز منفصل. The second one, مد جائز منفصل, we make it two or four حركات. You have option. You can say موسى إن two. You can also make it four. موسى إن. Both are okay. لمدركون دال. دال having سكون. This one we say قلقلة. We say قلقلة. قلقلة. What are the letters of قلقلة? Five. قاف دال باء طاء قاف. To make it more easy for you to memorize, remember these two words. قطب جد. This is the five letters of قلقلة. Remember these two words. قطب جد. قطب جد. These are the five letters of قلقلة. قاف طاء باء جيم دال. قطب جد. So easy to know and to memorize قلقلة. So when we have one of these five letters with سكون, at the time I make قلقلة. Like this one. مدركون. مدركون. I don't say مدركون. No, I say I make قلقلة. Means moving the letter of دال. قال كلا إن. This one مد جائز. جائز منفصل. جائز منفصل. Because two words. إن غنة. إن معي ربي سيهدين. فأوحينا إلى. مد جائز منفصل. Two or four حركات. موسى أن. جائز also. مد جائز منفصل. Two or four حركات. أنضرب. أنضرب بي. Look here. We have با and then با. This one. اضرب بعصاك. اضرب باء سكون. Then after that another باء. باء كسرة. بي. So اضرب بي. So we have باء سكون plus باء كسرة. So when we have same letter coming in order like this one, first one having سكون, second one having حركة means فتحة ضمة كسرة, at the time we make something called إدغام. إدغام it means it will be one letter. This one will be one letter. So this one will be, this one will be باء شدة كسرة. So it will be this one. In the Mus'haf, if you look, there is no sukun written. Nothing written. And then for باء he made شدة and then كسرة. Usually there are two ways. You can make like this شدة and then كسرة together like this. You can make like this. Another way to make the تجديد only up and then the كسرة down. Both are okay. Okay. So in the Mus'haf you find like this one. اضرب بي عصاك. So we say here إدغام. إدغام. We say this one إدغام. إدغام. We say مثلين. إدغام مثلين. مثلين means same letter. So when we have بابا إدغام مثلين. We have تاتا إدغام مثلين. We have ميم ميم إدغام مثلين. But very important, the first one having سكون. It's important. First one having سكون. And second one having another حركة. فانفلقا. Here we have نون سكون then فاء. This one we say إخفاء حقيقي. إخفاء حقيقي. It means I will hide the نون in فاء. I will not say فانفلقا. فانفلقا. No. I will say فانفلقا. I hide the نون in فاء. فانفلقا. Like this one. فكان كل فرق ك. Same. You say إخفاء حقيقي. إخفاء حقيقي. Same. كالطود العظيم. وأزلفنا ثم غنى الآخرين. وأنجينا نون سكون and then جيم إخفاء حقيقي. وأنجينا موسى ومن معه إدغام بغنة. إدغام with غنة not مثلين because this one نون سكون and then مين. معه أجمعين. This one we say مد صلة كبرى. معه أجمعين. معه أجمعين. Then we have قلقلة on جيم. أجمعين. ثم غنة. أغرقنا قلقلة or قاف. Yes. الآخرين. إن غنة. في ذلك لآية. لآية وإدغام with غنة. وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين. أكثرهم مؤمنين. Yes. إدغام مثلين. مين مين. وإن غنة ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم. واتل عليهم نبأ إبراهيم. إبراهيم قلقلة. also for ta utlu ta. Yes, this ta we make something called hams. Listen to me, I say watlu. I don't say watlu. If I say watlu, the ta will be, how to say, very very strong. But we release the ta sukun by saying watlu. We give it something like seen, but not complete, not complete seen. Watlu, watlu, like this one. This one we called it hams. We say hams. إذ قال لأبيه وقومه مد صلة ما تعبدون قالوا نعبد أصناما أصناما ف إخفاء حقيقي فنظل لها عاكفين قال هل يسمعونكم. You see the word عاكفين, this word remind you something, اعتكاف in Ramadan اعتكاف. This word also عاكفين from same root اعتكاف. It means they spend a lot of time worshipping the idols. عاكف like معتكف, like the one who made اعتكاف in masjid, but they are making اعتكاف for أعوذ بالله أصمام. قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون. Here brothers, إذ, yes, ذال, ذال سكون. Some brothers confusing. For ذال they make قلقلة, they say إذا. This wrong, because ذال it's not from قلقلة letters. So when you have ذال سكون you say إذ, not إذا. Yes, like now إذ تدعون, look, إذ تدعون. Yes, I don't say إذا تدعون, I said إذ تدعون, إذ تدعون. Okay, please take care of this. I know it's difficult for some people, but try to practice inshallah. إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما تعبدون. We are on which ayah? 73. Yes. أو ينفعونكم. ينفعونكم إخفاء حقيقي. أو يضرون. قالوا بل وجدنا قلقلة. وجدنا آباءنا. مد جائز منفصل تو أور فور حركات. Then آباءنا مد واجب متصل فور حركات. That's why I said brothers, especially who are not new, who are new brothers, you bring notes and write after me. كذلك يفعلون. قال أفرأيتم ما, ميم سكون, another ميم إضغام مثلين, كنتم إخفاء حقيقي, تعبدون, أنتم إخفاء حقيقي, وآباؤكم واجب متصل فور حركات, الأقدمون قلقلة, فإنهم غنة, عدو لي إضغام وذود غنة, لي إلا مد جائز منفصل, الذي خلقني فهو يهدين, والذي هو يطعمني قلقلة, طاء يطعمني ويسقين, وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين, والذي يميتني ثم يحيين غنة. والذي مد جائز منفصل تو أو فور حركات أطمع قلقلة أن يغفر إضغام إضغنة خطيئتي مد واجب متصل فور حركات يوم الدين رب هب لي قلقلة حكما وإضغام إضغنة ألحقني قلقلة بالصالحين. So now الحمد لله we studied the rules of تجويد of this page. If something not clear for you, you can ask إن شاء الله. باء
the letter of قطبجد will,
yes, yes,
will do
yes.
خلقلة
yes, yes. If there is سكون
if there is سكون
yes yes
yeah,
if there is no سكون no قلقلة
yeah.
And the سكون brother is two types we have سكون we say سكون أصلي سكون أصلي سكون أصلي like you see the سكون written like for example the last ayah okay الحقني you see قاف the سكون is written here you can see the سكون this one we say سكون أصلي if it is written but sometimes we have another سكون we say سكون عارض سكون عارض عارض because we stop very simple example when you say قل هو الله أحد actually this دال in القرآن أحد but when we recite we stop here so when we stop this one became سكون but it's not written not written so this one we say سكون عارض okay but the other one which is written like what we saw in the page we say سكون أصلي so remember this two أصلي and عارض yes إخفاء حقيقي yes
سكون أصلي
Yes, but actually, إخفاء حقيقي, this for noon.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, like, for noon. So, no, yes, yes.
There are two kinds.
Yeah, of course, of course.
Yeah. Okay.
Of course, this one, إخفاء. Yes, yes, right, right, right. Any other? Yes, brother Ihsan. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
I'd like to ask about the story of Musa when the Firaun crossed the sea. The Quran said that actually there is two questions. My first question is when the Firaun crossed the sea and the sea which parted before become like meet each other again. I mean like yes, merge again. When Fir'aun said, when Fir'aun sang in the Quran, he said that he believed in Allah, he believed what the Prophet Musa alayhi salam believed. But there is an hadith which say that the angels, the malaika, blocked his mouth by mat, so he can't say shahadah before that.
Fir'aun?
Yes, in a hadith.
No, no, where is the hadith, this one?
Maybe I'll show you later. That the malaika like put the mud into his mouth. So he
mud.
Yeah, yes, mud. Yes. So he can't say shahada before he dead.
Ah, he couldn't. He couldn't. Huh? Sorry, you said he did or not? He didn't. He didn't. Yes.
So the purpose of the angel yes, put
yes.
the mud.
Yes. Yes. So yes. Like, so, this is true. This is true. Yes.
So
I was mistaken hearing that you said he said.
he didn't no, say
it. He didn't say it.
So,
because it's clearly in Al-Quran. In Al-Quran, yes. Allah said very clearly
yes.
that Fir'aun, he couldn't say La ilaha illallah. Even he said the words that I believe in what Bani Israel believing.
Yes.
But he couldn't say, I believe La ilaha illallah. He couldn't say this word, La ilaha illallah. Okay? Why? Because to say La ilaha illallah, it means you have some excuse of receiving forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stopped any possibility for him to receive any forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay?
So he didn't say La ilaha illallah,
No. He couldn't. The other question?
Okay, let's talk.
Okay, inshallah. Okay, brothers, any other question, inshallah? Also, sisters in upstairs, if they have any questions, they can send to even by writing to brother Afif. Now, inshallah, we go to the hadith. The hadith. As we know, alhamdulillah, every week we read one hadith from the book of Riyadu al-Salihin. The chapter is 14. Okay. Yes. The title of that chapter is Babun fil iqtisad fi ta'a. Or ibadah. In the book here written ta'a, ibadah, it's okay. Both are okay. Means moderation in worship. This is the meaning of that title. As usual, Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, he used to start by some ayat of Al-Quran and then the hadith. So he started by the first ayah, Surah Taha. Taha, ma anzalna alayka al-Qur'an litashqa. Taha, we have not sent down the Qur'an unto you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to cause you troubles. The second ayah, Surah Al-Baqarah 185, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends to for you ease, and he doesn't want you make things difficult for you. Okay? The hadith عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم دخل عليها وعندها امرأة قال من هذه؟ قالت هذه فلانة تذكر من صلاتها قال مه عليكم بما تطيقون فوالله لا يمل الله حتى تملوا وكان أحب الدين إليه ما داوم صاحبه عليه متفق عليه. So this hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha. I will explain to you the hadith in the easy way. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, one time the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered her room. Okay? And at that time, one woman was inside the room. One woman guest with Aisha radiallahu anha. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man hadhi? Who is this?" Asking about that woman. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, she is, and she mentioned about her that she, mashallah, praying a lot of nafl and making a lot of prayers, a lot of ibadat like this. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Mah," addressing her. He said, "Mah" means wait, wait. عليكم بما تطيقون. Do what you can do. The meaning, brother, not to do some ibadah which is very hard for you to do. Always choose the ibadah which you can do and you can continue doing it. Why? Because sometimes Shaitan having trick for worshippers by asking them to do ibadah which is very hard. So when a person doing this ibadah hard, he cannot continue. He can do it one time, two time, but after that he will feel tired and cannot continue it. Okay, cannot continue it. Like one time the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, Abdullah, don't be like one person. Don't be like him. And he said one person, but he didn't mention the name. That man, he used to make tahajjud and then he stopped. Sometimes a person make tahajjud, alhamdulillah, very good. But you have to continue, not to stop. Even with a little. You can make tahajjud even with little rak'at. Better than to make tahajjud, for example, for 1 hour, 2 hours tahajjud, but do it for one time, two times, and then stop completely. This is not good. This for every ibadah. Every ibadah you are doing, try to do it according to your ability. Okay? And then continue doing it. Continue doing it. It's better than to start something very great and then stop. That's why here the Prophet ﷺ said, فَاللَّهُ لَا فَوَاللَّهِ لَا يَمَلُّ اللَّهُ حَتَّى تَمَلُّ means the meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not cut your reward for your deeds until you leave the deeds. And as long as you are doing the good deeds, even it's a little, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeping rewarding you until you stop. If you stop, then the reward will stop. حَتَّى تَمَلُّ وَكَانَ أَحَبُّ الدِّينِ إِلَيْهِ. Actually, this the last sentence, this is the saying of Aisha. It's not the hadith. It's not the hadith. It's saying of Aisha. كَانَ أَحَبُّ الدِّينِ إِلَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes the continuation of the good deeds if a person continue doing it. Sorry, I mistaken. كان أحب الدين إليه. This is the same words in the hadith. Not Aisha رضي الله عنها. It's in the hadith. Allah سبحانه وتعالى likes the deeds which are doing continuously, even it's a little. Yes. So it's actually a very great lesson for every Muslim. For ibadah. To do the ibadah according to your ability. But also don't misunderstand. This is for the nawafil, not for fara'id, not for fard. Fard you have to do. Don't misunderstand. Say, okay, so I instead to pray 5 times, I will pray 2 times. This not correct. Okay, this hadith applying for the nawafil. Okay, for the sunan. But not for fard. Okay. Tahajjud sunnah. Tahajjud sunnah. Okay. If someone can do, alhamdulillah, he will be rewarded. Someone cannot do. Okay. It's a sunnah. But for fard, I cannot do these things. Yes. And actually, today we go to the next hadith. This hadith, actually, I will summarize it for you. This hadith talking about 3 people came to the houses of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking about his ibadah. Okay, so the people told them about the ibadah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then those people said, this is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in high position and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him. But for us, we are very weak and we need to do more ibadat. So the first person said, I will pray the whole night tahajjud from Isha to Fajr, Salat, tahajjud. The second one said, I will fast every day Sawm until my death. Every day Sawm, 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 Sawm. The third one said, I will not marry any woman. I will not marry. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came back and they told the people, told him about what these 3 people said. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Jazakallahu khair, Allah barik lak, barakallahu fik. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, to them, Ama inni wallahi by Allah, I am the best one among you in taqwa. No one in taqwa like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the best one. And he said, I am fasting some days and not fast other days. I not fast every day. And I sleep at the night and pray part of the night. And I marry 2 women. If anyone not following my way, he is not among my followers. So it means to say, I will make sawm every day, or I will pray tahajjud from Isha to Fajr. It's not good. Not good. Because you are not following the sunnah. The sunnah is to sleep and then woke up and pray. To fast some days and not fast other days. This is a sunnah. To marry. To marry. This sunnah also. If someone said, I will not do this kind of things, he is not following the sunnah. You're not following the sunnah. So, inshallah. Of course, as you know, we just read one hadith. But of course, for you, please, you can read the rest of, there are many ahadith. You can take the book and you can read the other ahadith. Okay, but for us, because of the time, we read only one hadith. So, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, for today, alhamdulillah, we finished. Read in the hadith class. And inshallah, just in few minutes, we'll start the last lecture, inshallah.
How do we know is the
okay? I want to ask yes. For the hadith. How do we know if the nawafils, the nawafil ibadah, is heavy to us if we don't try it? I just want to know. So because sometimes our iman is at the peak, at sometimes at the bottom. When the peak, we things like maybe I want to try to do, for example, duha or saums in the Monday Sunday.
Yes, yes.
But before that, we never do it. And then after we try it, we feel like, oh, it is heavy for me, for example.
Yes, yes.
And then, yeah, I cannot continue, for example, like that. How about it?
Yes, actually, this is the meaning of the hadith. Yeah, the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ guided us. If you want to start some ibadah, try to go gradually. For example, I start by fasting 3 days every month. This sunnah, 3 days every month. If I can fast 13, 14, 15, it will be the best. If I cannot, I can choose any 3 days, even one from the beginning, one from the middle, one, anyway. Okay. After I do that, I can increase. After I test the fasting and I know my ability, then instead to make 3 days, I can make 4. I can make 5. So gradually, but not to start by, for example, say I will fast 1 day and second day not fasting. Now you start very hard, and you difficult to continue in these manners. This is the meaning of the hadith. Always choose which is according to your ability to do, but to continue it. This important to continue it. This, mashallah, if you can continue it, inshallah, this is a good sign that, alhamdulillah, you are on the right path. If you continue it, unless there is something happening stopping you to do this, something out of your control. But even at the time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write for you the full thawab. Because you want to do, but you cannot do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows your situation. So this is the meaning of doing the things you can do, the ability. So the ability is different from one to one. Okay? But the most important, Brother Zaki, is to continue doing it. That's why in Ramadan, for example, if you remember, I always, every Ramadan, I remind myself and my brothers, try to continue the things you started in Ramadan, try to keep it with you in the whole time. In Ramadan, you, mashallah, recite Al-Quran every day. Try to make one khatm of Al-Quran in 1 month. Some people make more. Try to keep it with you after Ramadan. In Ramadan, I used to give sadaqat. Try to continue it after Ramadan, even with a little. In Ramadan, maybe I give big sadaqah. But after Ramadan, I cannot give the same. But I can give little. No problem, but continue. In Ramadan, adhkar, continue. Everything like this, inshallah. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows your niyyah, it's really pure, Allah will help you, inshallah, to continue.